During the Buddha's time, he often traveled to different cities to give people an opportunity to give alms and listen to the Dhamma. A very wealthy lay supporter invited the Buddha and his monks to come receive alms at his house. The lay supporter had a large house with a sprawling, beautiful garden. Many people were very excited to see the Buddha. After the meal, the wealthy man invited the monks to take a walk on the grounds and see all the beautiful sights. The lay disciple eagerly showed the monks his garden. Some of the monks asked, "Your garden is full of trees and flowers, yet in this section there are no trees. What happened here?" "Venerable sirs, the young man who was responsible for taking care of the trees in this section is the cause. He decided that the best way to care for the trees was to pull each one up and see how long its roots were. Then, he thought it would be most efficient to water the plants by pouring water directly onto the roots. He gave each plant water according to the length of the roots. Thereby, the trees all withered and died. When the Buddha was informed of this, he said, "This is not the first time that this young man has ruined a beautiful garden. He did the exact same thing in the past, many lifetimes ago. My lord, please tell me the story of the past that only you can see." A long time ago, when Brahmaratta was reigning in Benares, a festival was proclaimed in the city. Everyone came to enjoy the music, the food, and the company. In those days, a pack of monkeys lived in the king's royal garden. They ate the fruit from the king's trees and spent all day relaxing. The king's gardener badly wanted to go to the festival. However, it was his job to water the plants. He didn't think about his responsibilities or his duties. He didn't think about what would happen if he got caught going to the festival. All he could think about was the fun he expected to have at the festival. Desperate to find a way to go, the gardener racked his brain for ideas. The gardener thought, "These monkeys are always eating the fruit in the garden. Surely they will want to repay the favors they have received." He then said to the monkey's king, "Monkey, there is a very important thing I have to do in the city. Will you do me a small, simple favor?"
"Of course, what is it?"
"All you have to do is water the plants and trees. You can do it a few times during the day. That should be enough."
"No problem."
The gardener thought,
"Perfect. Now I can go and enjoy the festival and have my work done. Life is wonderful. I'm so happy.
And so, the gardener left the watering pots and pans for the monkeys and left to go to the festival. And so, the leader of the monkeys called everyone together and said,
"We have been given a job to do. We will do it wisely as a monkey would. We must not waste water. First, we must pull up the plants. Then we must look at the size of the roots. Then, the plants that have large roots will get plenty of water. The plants that have smaller roots will get less water. This is the wise way to water plants, because if we use all the water, where can we get more? We must ration it out wisely, as a monkey would."
"Very wise.
Very wise.
Very wise.
Very wise.
Great idea.
Amazing idea.
Amazing idea."
At that moment, a wise young man was walking by and noticed what the monkeys were doing. He asked, "Why are you monkeys watering the plants after pulling up tree after tree?"
"This is what our leader told us to do."
"Your leader, the Monkey King, is a foolish monkey, so it only follows that you will do foolish things. However, he is not the only one to blame. The gardener is also a fool for relying on monkeys to tend to the garden while he goes to the festival. Knowledge is what leads to success. Fools are thwarted by their foolishness, and just like these monkeys that killed the garden trees, even possessing the desire to do good, the ignorant and foolish only succeed in doing harm." The wise man then walked away after rebuking the leader of the monkeys. And so the Buddha concluded the Jataka. "This is not the first time that this young man has ruined a garden. He did so in the past as well. The young man who ruined the garden was the king of the monkeys in the past. And I myself was the wise man from the past."
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.